everybody. Hope you like my new video. I do go into a little bit more detail on how to use the laminate material to put inside of a component, and I've got the end result at the end of the video. There are other things that I've made, and I've been working on my Brent Spiner art. You can see behind me here some of my drawings, and I've been doing some watercolors. He is my muse, and I'm enjoying myself with my new muse. Hope you enjoy the video.
You need to start it and keep it flowing. I usually slowly swirl it, filling it from the center outward. Gauging the amount comes with practice. I watch for bubbles and try to push them to the edges if they appear. When it's filled, I sometimes need to tip it very carefully to help it flow to the edges. Try not to let it flow over the edges. At the end, I'll show you how it domes slightly over the top of the item. I then place it on a level surface to dry for a few weeks, and I usually tent it with a piece of paper over the top to keep the air fibers off. I'll show you the end results of this tutorial at the end of this video.
There are a couple of frames that I made. I put some painting, sparkly glitter type paint on that, on the frame. This one I put some glitter and some glow-in-the-dark paint, and these are just some of my favorite pics. There's a pic of me and Brent, and there's one of Data. He's actually smiling, and I'm pretty sure that's from the...
Intriguing.
There's a couple of quick snapping type pieces. Here's one, it's a magnet, and it has some painting around the edges, and that's a modified picture of Brent. This is just one of these inexpensive plastic magnets. I think I got that at the 99-cent store or something. I did put a bunch of painting on it, and I have a piece of a gift bag with the hologram effect in the background. And, of course, there's our beloved Data.
Startling. Quite extraordinary, in fact.
Here's a collection of Lore. You can tell I like a certain picture of Lore a lot. I do use it. This is just one of those frames that you can cut pictures out. You have little pieces of glass that you slide into the frame. I did put micaneous oxide on the frame, and I put some holographic bags behind the picture and then punched little holes in the picture, like with a star and a heart, so you can see the bag. And there's my artwork of Lore on the back of that. This is a frame, probably a scrapbooking frame, and this came out really good. You can tell I got a pretty good thick coating of triple thick in that one. And it just has a plain backing. I'm probably going to embroider around that one and make that into a focal point. Here's a little tag with Lore, and I used some different material. I used a gloss interior varnish for a lot of these. You do have to put on a lot of coats, but I was trying different materials, and I probably put about seven or eight coats on there, and that's just a little metal tag. It was probably pastel colored, and I really didn't like it pastel, and I do have Lore written on the back in a pen, in a marking pen, and Love underneath that. Here's a repurposed button. It's probably an old button that was faded out or I didn't like anymore. And there's a picture of Lore. I think it is an artistic picture of Lore. And there's probably about 10 coats of this gloss interior varnish over the top of that. It does work really nice. The only thing is that you do have to put on quite a few coats.
Lore.
There's quite a few things. I've got some fun magnet that I just made with multimedia pieces on it. Here's a piece of metal with layered Data and quite a few layers of a glossy top coat on that. Here are some pins with Data Noonien Sung and another little Data with his poker hat on. These are the ones that I glue to the cardboard and then make into pins. Well, first I put the laminate material in it and let it dry on a flat surface. Here's a fun little repurposed pin, which I'm going to be adding some dangles to. Here's one of space, and then I've continued the outline of the spiral onto the wood, and I did laminate and put some coatings on that, and that's nice and shiny. Here's two components, and the components come square, and you put the pictures in, and then you drop the stuff on it. There are little tiny bubbles in the corners, and I think it's because the corners aren't joined on these things. Excuse me. But it works really good. I'm still experimenting with that. There's another pin with our current gorgeous-looking Brent. Now, these pins here are the ones that I did with the interior varnish. It does take a lot of coats, but it turns out really nice if you're patient. Each time you do a coat, you do it in a different direction, like do it horizontally and then vertically and then each of the diagonals and then come back and do that all over again. So that takes about 8 coats. It was a lot of fun making all those.
Depends on an understanding of the relativistic curvature of space-time.
Here's some other fun things that I made. This is the start of the tags. And this is more like an artist card. It has some painting on it. It has some layering and some metal and decorative edging around the picture. That's a wonderful picture of Data with his wires exposed on his head. Here's a big old ornament, and I did it with a big picture of a close-up of Data, and of course a wonderful Brent's picture modified slightly, and I put a bunch of coats of the gloss interior varnish that's made by Dreamcoat on that particular ornament.
So far, it has proved to be most illuminating.
This is the final result of the earlier video I made when I was actually putting the laminate material in there. It came out really good. There's a couple of really slight bulges, but you really don't notice it. It's a really nice, thick, and shiny application. Excuse me. I did glue a pin back to the back, so that's going to become a pin. And that's just layers of scrapbooking material and easy laminates. Of course, a picture right out of my printer. And I glued all those things together and laminated the top, and that's the end result.
Excuse me. I didn't mean to scare you.
We always have a lot of fun with our muses in my obsession crafts. Of course, you can use whatever interest appeals to you. And when we have some new videos coming up soon, I've been doing a lot with some tags, and I hope to be posting that video. I want to thank you all for watching, and as always, take care.